Welcome. Thank you for coming tonight. My name is Maya Allison. I'm the incoming director and chief curator of the gallery that will someday be, that does not yet exist. And in the meantime, I'm overseeing the exhibition program here on campus. And I would like to thank the Institute for hosting this event for us. Tonight, we're opening the exhibition of MinD, body art, and performance art in the Gulf area. This is a landmark survey exhibition that was originally produced at DUCTAC in Dubai, which is an actual gallery, under the patronage of His Highness Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan bin Khalifa al Nahyan. Last spring, I attended the opening of this remarkable exhibition, along with many of my colleagues here at NYU, and we felt it would be wonderful to bring this work from contemporary artists in the region into dialogue with the curriculum here. We're delighted that the curator and artists agreed to the show, and it features many of the UAE and the region's most well-known artists, as well as very exciting young artists who are now emerging. I'd like to give the floor to the curator now. She can give you a brief introduction to the exhibition, and there'll be a little bit of time for questions, but we're gonna go pretty much right after her talk into a performance that will happen out in the courtyard. So you take a right out these doors and then left out into the garden, where we have the performance artist Rabi Georges, who will perform a new work that he's created specifically for our campus tonight. So please join me in welcoming Cristiana de Marchi. She's a curator, artist, and writer based in Dubai and Beirut, and we're pleased to have her here tonight. Thank you.
Good evening. It's my pleasure to present this exhibition here in NYU after having originally produced it for DUCTAC. The title of the exhibition is actually related to a format that DUCTAC has, which is an annual format, where it's made in Dubai. That's why you have two capital M and D. And then I just decided to use that acronym as a MinD and to oppose it to body, as the project is all about body art and performance and works which relate to body in the Gulf. This is a project that I started working a couple of years ago, and I couldn't find the right occasion to actually create the exhibition. And everyone knows there is a lot of attention now for what's happening in the Gulf, for what's happening in Dubai, especially with art fairs growing, and here in Abu Dhabi with Guggenheim coming and other important museums. The feeling is that nothing happened before the last 10 years, that everything developed so quickly, which is not true. And I found that through this specific subject matter, which is performance, an unusual one in a part of the world where, of course, the body is quite covered. It's not publicly displayed, and there are many restrictions, cultural restrictions on the use of body and its representation. Well, actually, through this specific subject, you can see a documentation of the beginning of contemporary art in the Gulf. So this exhibition, we have 16 artists, and we will see them quickly. I just choose to start with this work, which is Sheikh Al Masru work. And she's a young Emirati artist. This is obviously it's a sculptural piece. It's the only sculptural piece that we have in the exhibition. And it has become a little bit the logo of the whole exhibition, being also the cover of our catalog, that you will find a few copies of the catalog for your information. And this work has been chosen to introduce the exhibition because it's a very it engages, physically engages the audience. The moment you will see the work in person, you will really relate to the to the work itself. It really activates a sense of participation, a desire of touching all aspects which are always related to the idea of body. And it's an abstract work, of course, which is very important and introduces one of the themes of this exhibition, which is the representation of body and the issues related to the body without actually showing anything which would be offensive in this society. So all the issues, also gender issues, are very much at the core of these works, but they are never ostensibly proposed. So this is just a detail of the work. And then we start with few historic work. So I mentioned that the first works go back to the early 80s, and I'm specifically referring to Hassan Sharif's work. Hassan Sharif is a Dubai-based artist who studied in London between the end of the 70s and early 80s. He was exposed to all the Western schools of thought, especially to conceptual art and minimalism, which highly affected his future and successive production. So Hassan Sharif has worked between 1981 and 1986 in performance and experiment. All the performances are very, very minimal, like this one is called Jumping, and it's a piece which we had in the first display of the exhibition in Dubai. And then I will show you another work which is instead now replacing this work. So the whole performance consists in the artist jumping from right to left and left to right. This other work, which is called a dictionary, is based on the dictionary. So he just took the first pages for each letter and glued them on a plywood, and then took photographs according to a series of calculations that he made following his own system. But this would open a very long conversation about Hassan Sharif practice, and I can't go into details. And then took photos himself. So he was placing like a chair behind the plywood, then moving back to the camera, taking the photo, and then moving again to the next step. And this is very interesting, and it opens on another issue that the exhibition is exploring, which is the documentation, the very nature of documentation here in the Gulf. Because mostly these artists have self-documented the performances, performances that very often had no audience, so the artist was just creating the whole performance. He was performing in front of a camera, very often just with few clicks, so not a video documentation. And then for a long time these works have been kept into drawers. The first time we are showing this work in the UAE. So it's this is a very important aspect of the of performance in this part of the world. And this is another work, it's slightly later, it's a 1994 piece. It's called Tongue, and it consists of 45 photos, which are you will see this kind of a display in the upstairs. So there are four boards, and these are the original photos. You see they are quite yellowish, not very well preserved, and. But it was an intentional choice from the curatorial point of view to show this one and not new prints out of the original photos, because again the issue of archiving is very is very critical, especially now with this interest about artists in this part of the world, also artists who were working before the late generation. We have many works which have been lost, many works which have not been properly preserved, and anyway, this is a major subject for the preservation of contemporary artworks in general. So you can see that in this case, it was Hassan Sharif documenting this performance of Mohammed Kazem. And so it was a kind of a collaboration between artists, something that very often happened in this specific area. Another work which is also dating to the same period is Nujum al-Ghanem performance. This is a performance, again, which has never been shown, and it's linked to a poetic text. Nujum al-Ghanem is a very well-known filmmaker and poet, and it's I chose well, it's you will see it. It's a very interesting piece, but I wanted to show it in and to connect it to the work of Mohammed al-Mazrui, because both are poet and artist. And Mohammed has, as you see, we have these sketches, which are also belonging to the same period. These are 1994 sketches. And of course, this is not strictly performance, but it's again into the use of body. And you see that we have another couple of them, a 1994 and the 1996 pieces. So here again, we have a use of an observation, let's say, of the body and the representation of the body, which immediately evokes issues of gender, and it's highly symbolic, just like Nujum piece. So these are not, I would say, they are not strictly questioning the reality, they're not questioning the political situation, they are more into a different state of mind, which is also one of the aspects of the performance. So we have these elements of the, we said many works have been self-documented. One of these pieces, which is a video piece, and it's Abdullah Al-Saadi video, part of a long-term project started in 2000 and ended in 2010, which is titled Naked Sweet Potato. So in this performance, you will see the artist, again, with a fixed camera that he installed himself, and the quality of the video, I'm afraid, is not that perfect, but that's the state of the documentation that we have. And he is tracing the shapes of these naked, these potatoes, the sweet potatoes on the ground in the area of Khorfakkan, where he lives. Another work which is very interesting is Anas al-Sheikh work. He's a Bahraini artist. And we have here two pieces. One of them is called Traces, which is questioning the issues of what's left of a human beings after their passage on Earth. And the second piece, which is a video piece, is a very political piece. It's called My Land. And it's investigating issues of sectarianism and division. In general, of course, all these artists are inspired by the context where they live in. So being a Bahraini artist with all the political situation of these late few years creates a sense of eco, but it definitely applies to a more universal situation and context. We have also the work of Tarek Al-Hussein, an artist that you know as a teacher as well here at NYU. So we have this series in consideration of myth, where there is, on the contrary, the exploration of a certain relation between the individual and the space through enacting specific actions of the myth, of the mythologies. And it is very interesting in my personal opinion, because it is almost, these are photographs, but it's almost in between a photograph and the video. It's something like as if it was just a still from a video, where you have a whole movement presumed by the last step, and you can at some point vision it in your mind. So it's a very it creates a true dialogue with the audience. Here it's another one, and then we have a series of works mostly by women artists, which definitely deal with issues related to the woman condition in the Gulf. This is Ebtissam Abdulaziz. It's a work which has been originally produced by Sharjah Biennial and displayed this way in the Sharjah Biennial in 2011. So it's called Women's Circle, and the circle in this case symbolizes the roles women are forced into. But of course, it is always around the body of the alter ego of the artist here performing. But there is a kind of a very strong feeling of playfulness in this work. So it's very ironic and openly addresses the capacity of women to overcome the restrictions and those roles, and to play around them. Another work which has evokes issues related to the women condition is Manal Al-Dawayan photographic work. Manal Al-Dawayan is a Saudi artist now based in Dubai, and this work, which is it's a photo montage, where she is questioning the idea of space and the relation again between the individual and the space, but with a special attention to the woman. So, and it's based on a certain idea of landscape as a place which doesn't exist, which is just in our imagination, or it's just a projection. It's not something where you actually live. You look at the landscape, but you live on a road, in a square. You are in a building. It's something that it's at some point not connected. And these silhouette of the women are the only presence in this landscape, also associated with these oniric symbols. And it's also questioning the issue of power and who is actually creating the restrictions, the mental restrictions that we have to comply with. So it's a very complex project. Another work of a Bahraini artist is this Talking with God, and it's a performance, it's a staged performance, in the sense that Wahida asked a few ladies from the village where she found these palm trees, and she decided to set her performance, so to climb the tree. It goes back to apparently a belief which is common in the Gulf. I don't know if it's here also or it's just in Bahrain, where women go to the graves of good men and they wrap this green fabric. Then they go to the mosque and they ask for their wishes to be realized. And through these, it's very interesting because it questions once again the role of women and their right to equally talk to God, let's say, because they can't do it directly. They have to do it through the good men. So it's a very subtle message that she's giving and. It has many other implications as a work as well. This is a work of an Iranian artist, a young Iranian artist now living in the States, Zayed Karimi, and it's ID project. It's a project that she has finally realized in 2012. But it has a long process in the sense that she asked many women in Iran to be portrayed in her studio. And at the same time, she asked them to have one of their ID. So it obviously revolves around the contradiction between the public and the private way we are seen and we want to be seen, or we would like to be seen, but we can't because there are cultural restrictions which must be respected.
All in black pictures.
Pardon?
All of them are in black color.
All of them. Actually, they are superimposed, two images. So the image of the ID photograph, and then you can see it, perhaps the photo here, the image is not very, very clear, but you will see the work. And then you can see slightly the image that the photograph that was taken in the studio where they could remove their veil and just be naturally photographed the way they wanted. So it's, and there is a small, here it doesn't show, but in the work there is a small mirror where actually you can see yourself reflected and choose the way you want to be portrayed. And another Iranian, I mentioned we have a couple of Iranian artists. The second one is Siavash Yansouri. Again, he's a very young artist, and he's questioning issues related to consumerism. So when he went to the States, at first he was really shocked by the proportions of consumerism, which is something that obviously we all know about, but when you are directly exposed to giant boxes of chips or I don't know, whatever, then it can be a little bit distressful. And another work which also questions the situation here again, back to Bahrain, is Nur al-Bastaki Path and Steps. And it's clearly a stage performance on the pipeline in Bahrain. And it's directly questioning the future of the young generations who are growing literally. I mean, they can live thanks to the presence of oil in these countries, but oil is also a bit threatening. So it's a contradiction between where to position oneself. And so she's showing this project, which has been created in 2006 and has been once exhibited in UAE. In the Sharjah Biennial 2007, which was, in fact, themed around environment. And then we have mentioned that mostly these performances have no audience, and all of them, which we saw, never had audience. And here we have the case of two performances, which are the last two. This is actually my work. And in this case, the performance, was a set in the fish market in Sharjah, which means that there were no called audience. There was no invitation, But audience was forced there because at some point the customers of the fish market and the people working at the fish market were in the situation that they couldn't escape. It was there. And that was an interesting experience, I must say, to see the reaction and reactions. In this specific context, I can say that there is very little knowledge about, there is little exposure to performance. So when people attend a performance like we did in March at the opening of MinD Body in Dubai, there were very very strong reactions, I would say. There was a very high level of participation, and which most probably if the same performance happened in London or New York would be very, very different. And this is Rabi Georges, so you will see after this short presentation his performance in the courtyard. Rabi Georges is an artist of Syrian origins who has been educated in Germany and now lives in Dubai. And he really embodies in his performances, in his work, the cultural mix, I don't want to talk about conflict, but definitely about conversation between elements of his original culture and the acquired one. And as you will see, there are some recurrent elements in his performances. He uses elements which are highly symbolic, like the choice of colors, which are always white, black, and red. The use of flowers, the use of ink, the element of writing. Very often these elements are recurrent in his performances. And I don't want to say anything about what he's going to do tonight, because it must be something unexpected.
Thank you. Maybe he's listening.